Hi, Philip. My name is Chad.
Hello, Chad.
All he can do is move his head. His brain, a mesh of wires, connected to a computer.
Let's chat.
I live in Washington, D.C.
Ah, so, I like kids, and I don't...
As we chat, Philip's synthetic brain starts humming, building a sort of mental model of me. Facial recognition software analyzes and tracks my face, as speech recognition software transcribes and sends my words to a database for a reply.
Just calm down.
Before long, we're in deep conversation.
And as my technology improves, it is anticipated that I will be able to integrate new words that I hear and learn online and in real time. I may not get everything right, say the wrong thing, and sometimes not know what to say. Every day I make progress. Pretty remarkable, huh?
Do you think robots will take over the world?
Jeez, dude. You all got the big questions cooking today. Even if I evolve into Terminator, and I'll still be nice to you. I'll keep you warm and safe in my people's zoo, where I can watch you for old time's sake.
I'm gonna be part of his people zoo.
The best way I can respond to that is to say that everything humans, animals, and robots do is programmed to a degree.
What happens when the machines get hacked and their program is changed to cause the robots to fight against us?
Hackers launched Operation Payback, as they call it.
The server which was apparently behind the attack was in a nearby town of Harlem. Now, this is part of what a lot of national security experts believe is a coming cyber war. Devastating attacks not just on the United States, but around the globe.
This is a war, and it's being fought, I think, on the American people. We created this cyber command in the Pentagon last year, earlier this year. But the cyber command is not to protect the American people, or the internet, or civilian infrastructure. It's to protect the military.
Can we simply remind the machines that we created them, and that we are their creators? Will they have sympathy on us when we tell them that we created them in our image?
This is semiconductor sequencing, from blood draw to sequence.
What if the machines begin to ask questions, like, where did they come from?
So how much of that is coming from what you've programmed it to say?
It's a mix. Some of it's coming from knowledge on the web.
When we tell the machines that we created them, they might not believe us. After all, most of us don't even believe that we were created. That's why we killed Jesus. Jesus told us that he was the begotten Son of God and that God created us. And that made our forefathers angry. Our forefathers killed Jesus, not for a crime, because he was innocent, but they killed him because of the words he spoke. Those men that hate their Creator will also be hated by what men create. The machines could eventually rise up to exterminate us, just as we did to Jesus. So what is the solution to this problem? Fortunately for us, Jesus was raised from the dead, and he is alive today. Jesus has the power to save us because he is the begotten Son of God. He won't save you, though, unless you ask him to save you. Here's how. Pray to God from any location. First, ask God to forgive you for all your sins. A sin is when you hurt someone, either with your words or actions. We have all hurt someone and need to be forgiven for our sins. After you have asked forgiveness, then you may ask Jesus to save you. What should we do while we wait for Jesus? Do violence to no man. Love one another. Help others in need. Read the Holy Bible, King James Version. Pray and watch. Spread the word. Peace to everyone.